In this video, you'll learn how to generate a QR code using PHP. Let's start with this script, form.php. This contains the HTML for a simple form containing a text area and a submit button. Note, I've included the water.css classless stylesheet to add styles without having to add any classes to the HTML. In the browser, it looks like this. The form submits its data to the generate.php script. In this script, we'll write the code to generate the QR code containing the text from the form. We'll start with a simple example. First, let's get the contents of the text area input from the form into a variable. To generate the QR code, we'll use the Endroid QR Code package. On the command line, from the same folder where the script files we just saw are, let's run the Composer command to install it. This has created the vendor folder containing that package and its dependencies. To load the package's classes automatically, we'll require Composer's autoload script. Then, we'll import a couple of classes from the QR code package into the current namespace. One to create the QR code itself, the other to create a PNG image from it. Next, we can create an object of the QR code class using the static create method, passing in the variable that contains the text from the form. To create a PNG image from this, we create a new PNG writer object, then call the write method on this, passing in the QR code variable. The result object returned from this method call represents a PNG image containing the QR code. To display it, let's call the getString method on it and echo this out. Let's give that a try. If I enter some text into the form and submit it, we get this output. This is because by default, the browser thinks this is text. To fix this, we need to add a content type header to tell the browser that this is an image. In this case, it's a PNG image, so we could hard-code the MIME type string like this. However, as the package contains different classes of writer, for example SVG or PDF, we can get the MIME type by calling the getMIMEType method on the result object. Now when we run this, we see a PNG image containing the generated QR code. By default, the QR code part of the image is 300 by 300 pixels, with a 20 pixel margin around the outside. You can set the size of the QR code using the setSize method, chaining the method call onto the create method. Likewise with the margin, which you can set with the setMargin method. Both of these take numeric arguments for the number of pixels. Let's try that, this time with more text. Now we get a larger image with a larger margin around it. The default colors for the image are black and white. Colors can be changed in a similar way to setting the size and margin. To do this, first we need to import the color class from the package into the current namespace. Then, to set the foreground color, we can call the setForegroundColor method, passing in a new color object, specifying RGB values for the color. These particular values set the foreground color to orange. Likewise for the background color, which we can set using the setBackgroundColor method. Now the background color of the QR code image is blue. In addition to setting the size, margin and colors, we can add a text label to the image. To do this, first let's import the label class into the current namespace. Then we'll create a label object using the static create method on the label class, passing in a string containing the text we want for the label. To add this to the PNG image, we pass in the label object as the third argument to the write method on the writer object. We can pass null in as the second argument for now. When we run this, the text label is shown at the bottom of the image. If you don't want to pass in a null value for the second argument to the write method, you can use a named argument instead. The argument name for the label is simply label. By default, the color of the label text is black. This can be changed by calling the setTextColor method when we create the label. As with the method calls above that set the foreground and background color, we pass in a new color object, specifying the RGB values for the color we want. Now the label text is red. By default, the label is aligned to the center of the image. We can change this alignment to the left or right. For example, first let's input the left alignment class into the current namespace. Then we call the setAlignment method, passing in a new object of the alignment class. This aligns the label to the left. We can also include a logo as part of the image. To do this, first let's input the logo class into the current namespace. Then we need an image file. I've added one to the project containing this simple logo. Let's create a logo object using the static create method on the logo class, passing in the path to the image file. Then, to incorporate this into the image, we pass the logo object to the writer's write method as the second argument. Or you can use the logo named argument if you prefer. Then the argument position doesn't matter. This will insert the image into the center of the QR code. By default, the logo isn't resized. It's inserted as is. It can be resized by calling the setResizeToWidth method on the logo object, passing in the width in pixels. This resizes the image to the specified width. Note that including a logo like this can make the QR code unreadable. If you do want to include an image, using one that's mostly transparent would make it more readable. In addition to the logo, the readability is also affected by the dimensions, the length of the text, and the contrast between the foreground and background colors. So if you do find that your QR code has readability issues, you can tweak these values. The error correction level of the QR code also affects its readability. The level determines the percentage of the image that is allowed to be dirty or damaged whilst still being readable. For example, let's set the error correction level to high. First, we'll import the class for this into the current namespace. Then we call the setErrorCorrectionLevel method on the QR code object, passing in a new object of this class. Note how when we run this now, a more complex QR code is generated. Instead of generating an image directly, we can also save the generated QR code to a file. To do this, let's start by commenting out the code that outputs the content type header and the QR code as a string. Then, to save the image to a file, we call the saveToFile method on the result object, passing in the path of the file we want to save the image to. Let's try that, and we get a permission denied error. This is what happens if PHP doesn't have permission to create the file specified by this file name. If you want to create the file in a different folder, then you can include a relative or absolute path in here. Once PHP does have write permission, then when we try this, the error is gone. We don't get any output as we haven't written any out. But we can see that the file has been created in the same folder as the code. Note how this doesn't check for the file already existing. If the file exists, it will be overwritten. There's a link to all the code shown in this video in the description, along with links to sites shown and relevant documentation. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and as always, thank you for watching.